Hi guys, I'm Abhinav. This is my friend Jaideep. I'm at his house in Patiala, Punjab. And in the last video, I showed you his truck, the Isuzu V-Cross. We covered all extensive modifications on it. And as promised, now it's time to talk about his motorcycle trailer. Jaideep, as I understand, as you've told me, this is a custom trailer. It's not made by anybody else. It's something that you got made yourself.
Yeah.
By a few fabricators.
Yes.
To suit your requirements.
Yes.
Why don't
yes.
you tell us about it?
So, this trailer was actually a lockdown project. It was done during the lockdown last year. And so, we've got two small dealership locations around 30 minutes and 1 hour from Patiala, 60 kilometers almost. So, regularly we have to bikes there, yeah, transport bikes, rather than sending them through a transport carrier or someone else. Whenever I travel, I prefer having the trailer, and this easily tows two Royal Enfield motorcycles. They fit perfectly and saves a lot of man hours, saves the cost of transportation as well. And so during lockdown last year, I started designing, working on how I could make a trailer which could be towed behind the Isuzu and suit my needs.
Okay.
So we've used, and the fabrication was all done by, the same guy who does the bumper.
Okay.
For the Isuzu, the rear bumper. We'll actually share his details. If anyone in Punjab wants good quality metal fabrication done by somebody who knows what he's doing with practical application in mind, he's probably the best guy I know. So we'll share his details. He's not on any social media or anything.
We'll share the number
and his name, of course. So this is a 4x2 rectangular pipe.
Okay.
So this is what we've used as a ladder.
Okay.
So this is the mainstay, this is the main frame.
Okay.
This part is known as the tongue
okay.
of the trailer, and the same pipe extends till the end. And we've used the 2x2 inch square pipe of an equivalent gauge as the frame. And this is the main support structure, okay. the 4x2. And the width has been designed keeping the gypsy that I have, keeping the width in mind so that it doesn't sit wider than what it's being towed behind. So it becomes very convenient towing it behind the Isuzu because the trailer is not as wide as the truck. So even in traffic and on smaller roads, it's very easy. If the rear tires are crossing, if the truck is crossing, the trailer is coming behind you. You don't even have to worry about the line of it going out of line. So this is all 10 gauge metal. This is a stone guard. So when you run on any broken roads, or as roads in India are, smaller roads, so your rear tires tend to throw a lot of pebbles.
Right.
So since I tow brand new vehicles mostly, mm-hmm. brand new motorcycles, those pebbles can cause paint chips.
Yeah.
They'll cause the paint to chip. So this is a stone guard. It's a very common feature in a lot of trailers. So I studied a lot of motorcycle trailers that companies are making abroad. I had a lot of time during lockdown, so we spent a lot of time doing research. And so this is to avoid pebbles and stones hitting the motorcycles in the back. We've mounted a spare tire, and this is from a manufacturer in Ludhiana. We were looking for it for quite a while. So this is exported to be used for boat trailers.
Okay.
So this is height adjustable. So you can slide it up and down, locks in place, and you can make it go high and low. It can go as low as you want.
Okay.
And it takes the entire weight. It is rated for almost 1100 kilos.
Wow.
So once this thing is opened up and down, you can roll around the trailer. You were helping me hitch it just a while back. So you've seen how easy it is single-handedly to push it around, chain direction. It's very convenient. So this takes the load for the front. You can unhitch, load, and even with the bike, you can push it around, it'll take all the load. There's nothing to worry about. This, I have mounted this as, this is your jerry can holder that comes on regular Army, Mahindra, Jeeps and all. So, if required, I can always fit a jerry can in here. These are my emergency, in case the tow hook gives away.
Okay.
This is to hold the trailer in place. This is just to keep it with the truck.
Okay.
These are not supposed to
take any weight or be pulled.
They'll pull it behind, but they can't put it, keep it up. They'll just keep it with the truck.
Yeah.
So that it doesn't go off. This is actually, you cannot tow without these chains abroad. In India, there's no specification on how you tow. This is my 5-point connection. That's everything taken from my tail lamp to all the lighting. We'll cover the lighting on the trailer.
Okay.
And that is an Army ammo box. That's an ammunition box that we use to keep the straps, locks, clamps, all small practical stuff that is required on the trailer.
You were telling me this is waterproof.
Yeah, since it's an ammo box, so all ammo boxes, they have to be waterproof. So it comes with a rubber liner, was green initially, we painted it black to match the trailer. So the lock very nice, and this is a turnbuckle which was cut in half to make a towing point, and I can adjust the tongue length by up to almost 8.5-9 inches, and that is just for different vehicles you can use different lengths of the tongue.
Right.
I generally run it in the middle. I've never had any issues. So these are my lights. I've got marker lights on the side. So half of the light is working with my parking. When the parking on the truck is on, these will light up. The other half is with my turn signal. So if you turn, they'll give you a... they'll light up. And this is the interesting part actually. So these are very special tires. These are rally tires mounted on a 13-inch simple alloy wheel. So these tires have almost an inch thick sidewall.
Wow.
Yeah, they're meant for abuse, and even if they go flat, even with two motorcycles loaded, they won't you can still roll the trailer and they won't go down basically.
Right.
So the sidewall is it's almost this thick. It's a very, very solid sidewall. And underneath you can see there's the suspension. So we've transplanted a complete Zen rear suspension under the trailer with the links and spring mounts and everything. And even the trailer is running Ironman dampers. I had dampers from a previous Thar with me. So those were transplanted. The springs are heavy. We bought separate custom springs to meet, because initially I was facing the issue of the springs sagging too much on two bikes. So I actually damaged a couple of tires initially with the sides hitting the tires under extreme compression when it was loaded too much. And now it's perfectly fine. And the pin, if you can see, it's a very, very interesting suspension part. The top is on a ball. So the pin goes through a ball, and when this suspension moves up and down, it exerts force on two axes. So that ball moves, it can pivot inside the ball, and that's the kind of suspension we do for rally cars in the front.
Right.
So that it doesn't break. The pins don't break that way. Okay. And this is, we've tried using it here as well. So, and another thing, for the trailer to be light, only the sides were made in metal. This is called hardwood.
Okay.
This is used for making floorings of trucks normally.
Okay.
So it has three metal mesh layers pressed inside the plywood. So this is completely waterproof ply and very lightweight.
Okay.
So the whole purpose of having this trailer light is that it is easy to maneuver around, and if the trailer itself is weighing so much, what am I supposed to load and tow?
Yeah.
So the structural rigidity has to be there, but you don't need to add weight.
Yeah.
So instead of having a metal sheet, we had this, and it is anti-slip, it doesn't slip. So this was just bolted on the metal frame that was made. And the rear bumper was taken from a Gypsy.
Nice.
And the tail lamps, everything works. I get parking, brake, turn and reverse.
Wow.
Everything works, and that is the only requirement for Punjab and Himachal. That is where I mostly use the trailer, and Delhi at times. You need to have your registration number,
yeah,
same as the vehicle that you're towing, and you just have to have the registration number on your trailer as well. And I'll show you something. So this is the ramp,
yeah,
that we use to take the bike up and down. It fits in all three places.
So if you want to load two different motorcycles,
yeah,
you can place the ramp on,
yeah,
the
you
side
place the ramp and you just, yeah, take it straight, yeah, up. Because once loaded on one side, it's difficult to maneuver if your ramp sits in one place.
Yeah.
And it's a very lightweight ramp. I'll show you the underside. So you see, this is, I think, 2 mm aluminum sheet.
Okay.
And just an inch by inch and an inch by 2 inch rectangular pipe.
Okay.
That's it. So it's not that heavy. It's easy to carry.
You've loaded some heavy motorcycles on this, including your Yamaha XP.
I've loaded the XP, Fat Boys, the Multistrada.
Mm-hmm.
This, I think, is one of the heaviest and probably the biggest motorcycles being
That's
sold in India.
Motorcycle.
So we'll be taking it for a wash now. And yeah, so the ramp goes, slides in, locks into place so that we've got a latch and lock underneath so that it doesn't come off and hit somebody on the road. And we've got mud flaps. Oh, there's another interesting thing I'll show. So normally, like we loaded today, the trailer was already hitched.
Mm-hmm.
So we didn't need a stand in the back.
Yeah.
Otherwise, if the front is down,
yeah,
you need something to support the back, because otherwise once the weight comes in the back,
yeah,
it's gonna pop a wheelie.
Yeah.
So we've got a neat stand.
Okay.
Yeah. Let me unhook it and
Oh,
so now, right, since it's loaded, yeah, it won't open all the way.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you open it, it sits,
yeah,
and then you attach the ramp.
Okay.
And it goes and it locks back into place. Everything is really dirty. This trailer just did a trip of Manali a couple of weeks back. So.
And it had two bikes on it?
Yeah, two motorcycles.
Wow.
And yeah, so this, other than that, there's a few things that you have to keep in mind while designing a trailer. The bit in front of your stone guard is what you call the tongue. This is your trailer body. Ideally, a trailer should be light enough that no matter how much load you have, you should be able to pick it up from the front. An ideal trailer should have only 10% of the total load effective on the tongue. So if my trailer has 1,000 kgs of load, the tongue should be 100 kgs heavy. So ideally, when I run around two motorcycles in fields, 160, 170 kgs, 350 kgs of load, add another 100 from the trailer, so 450 kgs, let's say, the tongue weighs only 45 kilos. So even if I have to lift and hitch, you can easily do that. For that, you have to take care of this part where your axle sits. Your axle is supposed to sit between 55% to 65% of your bed length. Gets a little technical, but that is how you calculate where your axle sits. It is too forward, it is going to pop a wheelie again. It's too much in the back, the front gets heavy.
Yeah.
So you have to find a balance of where your axle ideally sits. I think this one we did at exact 55%, and I've never had any issues.
Okay.
I push around the trailer with
And you made multiple trips on this trailer.
Multiple trips. I've used the
motorcycles from one dealership to the other.
From one dealership to the other, from here to Manali, here to BIC.
And BIC is a good 300 something kilometers away.
Yes.
So is Manali.
So is Manali is around 350 from Patiala. So never had any issues.
Okay.
And the roads to Manali are really bad. But I've never had any issues, and these we've added multiple strapping points. There's three on the top. There's another two. All of these are made from U-bolts that you hold shackles with, suspension shackles. So these are all chopped U-bolts. You can see these are all chopped U-bolts that I've used, and these are your hoops that fit on. These are basically bolt-on hoops. That rings that you use to carry electric motors and all. So these are good quality forged strapping points. These are from Mahindra Jeep. So these I use when I'm normally loading two motorcycles. And these straps are each rated at 400 kgs, ratchet straps, and they're very solid. These I picked from a friend of mine. So when a Harley bike, a CBU bike comes to India, it's loaded on a pallet and it is secured down with these straps. So I got these for free from him, and I've collected quite a few of these, and that's about it. I think we've covered most of the trailer parts. The bumper sides are again from the Gypsy, so it gives it a very neat look. I've added a small towing point in the back. The pin locks in and you can pull anything if need be, and maybe if you can attach a photo in the dark when the lights are on, it looks really nice with all the lights turned on, and we'll take a photo then.
So Jerry, how much time did it take you to put this trailer together?
I think around 2.5-3 months.
Okay.
Three months.
And a trailer like this, now I know that, you know, this is a one-off, it's not a commercial trailer.
Yeah.
You built it for yourself. But let's say with all the suspension components and everything that's there on this trailer, what kind of value are we looking at? How much money would it cost somebody if they want to get a trailer like this made?
I think I've invested around 85 to 90,000 in the trailer, minus my man hours. And
safe to say close to a lakh of rupees?
Close to a lakh of rupees. I think it goes to almost a lakh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess that's pretty much it. And by the way, guys, this is...
Jackie.
Pet. Jackie.
Okay.
He
wants
to 3.5 months old.
Wants to pull on the mic cable now.
Yeah. Alright guys, so we're gonna end this video over here. Jerry, thank you so much for sharing these insights.
You're welcome.
About your trailer.
You're welcome.
And your truck. Guys, I'm gonna give you a quick sideways look of the trailer, how big it is. Now the Tiger 1200's one of the really largest dimension motorcycles that's sold in India, and it fits completely on the trailer. If you'd see only the top rack plate, which is an additional accessory that's slightly outside the trailer, otherwise Jerry, most motorcycles, they fit perfectly in line.
They're always
inside.
They're always inside. Yes. They don't stick out. Oh, and we missed one thing. So these marker flag poles.
Yeah.
I have these on both ends.
Okay.
So these are actually very helpful when you reverse a trailer.
Yeah.
So, because the trailer is low and I can't see it in my rear view.
Yeah.
So, these are used as a reference point.
Okay.
So, these are mounted at the exact edge of the trailer.
Okay.
So, while reversing, I know till where my trailer extends.
All right.
Because otherwise, you can't really make out where the trailer is.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much, Jaideep.
Thank you.
All right, guys. This was Jaideep's trailer. So we're going to wrap this video up. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.
Bye.